Okay guys, welcome to another series of 2 JD sessions. Have you ever wondered why it comes with 2 turbos? Why not 1? Why not the popular single turbo? My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to show you guys 2 JD GTE twin turbo. How does it work? Right, coming up! So the main reason is to solve the lag issues. Okay, although this one is a 6-cylinder 3000cc, but it still has some lag issues if you put a single turbo. Alright, so what does it do is, it has twin turbo, so when it has it is cruising or it is idling at low RPM, the exhaust gas is blowing one of the turbos, and then it is cooling already. So the exhaust easily fills up the primary turbo. And then after that, then after certain RPM, the engine is producing more exhaust gas already. So the manifold that I'm going to show later is going to open and let the secondary turbo do its way. Okay guys, I purposely open it up so that it is facing you. So actually it is like this. Okay, so this one is the front side. Okay, this one is the rear side. I purposely open so that I can let you guys see this one. There is one wastegate actuator. You can see this one is shut off already. This one is true. So there is one actuator. In order to reach certain RPM, it will open. Okay. So from this, I can immediately know that this one is your primary turbo. This one, when it reaches certain RPM, it will open up. It will allow the secondary turbo to run. Right, so the primary turbo, so I can trace back the air, the exhaust flow, reverse engineering. If you guys can see from here, this one connects to here. So this one is our primary turbo, the rear one. Okay, so you can see that there is a 6-cylinder here. These three connect to this, these three connect to this, and these two are connected together. So what happens is the exhaust go through here, and the exhaust will be allowed to go through the downpipe. Okay, but at the same time that the exhaust is also filling up the second turbo. So when it is filling up, but the exhaust gas, it is going redirect to the one hole, to the single hole. Okay, but once the reach certain RPM, the this manifold will open. Right, this manifold will open and allows this one, the exhaust gas, to escape more from here. So this one is already spooled from the low RPM, but it's not enough. It still has a lot of lag, but the lag will be solved by this rear, the primary turbo. Then the second turbo kicks in when this valve open, and then more exhaust gas is allowed to go through, and more turning, more boost go to your engine. So this is how it works. Right, so there are a lot of people that go and change into single turbo configuration. Alright, so you can see this one is very nicely built by Tongka 2JZ. Tongka, actually Tongka, they are a CNC manufacturing shop in Malaysia. They are very prestigious, and they are selling internationally to Japan, to USA, and they also a sponsor for Pedro Osborne too. Definitely the 2JZ single turbo is the way to go for bigger horsepower. Although it is leggier, you can solve it with anti-lag and maybe bigger CC displacement and stuff like that, but single turbo is the way to go, right? So I hope you guys learned something from this video, and hope to see you next time. Okay, so I hope you guys learned something from this video. Please subscribe if you guys want to learn more about 2JZ, about engine building, and about ways how to save money for your car repairs. Alright, see you!